Hello and welcome to InstaBlog's Global Report. This is Sukhmani, fresh updates and more citizen voices from all over the world. Stories of the day are: Somali MPs appeal for help from international community, United States to send 4 brigades to Iraq in advisory roles, and food suppliers and marketeers facing prospective losses due to road blockages in Swat Valley. Around 50 Somali MPs and civil society leaders meeting in Nairobi have urged the international community to coordinate military and security support for the transitional central government regime and resuscitate Somalia's collapsed institutions. Sigeros Wanguyu from Kenya wishes that all African countries would speak in one voice and help bring normalcy to the war-torn country.
This is Rose Wanguyu, a citizen journalist from Kenya, reporting on InstaBlog. I would not agree more with the African Union, IGAD, and UN delegates' move to defend Somalia's illegal transitional federal government. The delegates have also defended AU peacekeepers' recent involvement in fighting against the rebels. I wish all African countries would speak in one voice and help bring normalcy to the war-torn country. On Tuesday, at an urgent meeting in Nairobi, Somalia's ambassador to Kenya, Mohamed Al-Nur, said TFG needs to recruit and train 6,000 security and military personnel in the next 6 months to surmount the growing Islamist threat that this country only happen with the help of other willing countries. The delegates have convened in the capital to draw a roadmap for coordinated military support for the TFG.
The Pentagon will deploy 4 army brigades to Iraq this fall to hold development and training duty. Sijawad Buzurek wonders whether America will ever totally leave Iraq free of its presence.
This is Wad Abu Zariq, reporting for the InstaBlogs from Jordan. The Pentagon announced that 4 brigades, which are labeled as Advisory and Assistance Brigades, will start deploying to Iraq this fall and will hold development and training duties in Iraq, which are announced to be the new American mission after the combats leave Iraq in 2010. Pentagon spokesman Brian Whitman said that the mission of those brigades will be to train and mentor Iraqi forces, as well as conduct counter-terrorism missions. This comes at a time when U.S. troops themselves are unable to really control terrorism in Iraq. With announcements such as this one, one cannot help but wonder if America will ever totally leave Iraq free of any American presence.
Farmers and traders in the war-torn Swat Valley are incurring loss in prospective earnings due to frequent road blockages that hinder their seasonal produce of fruits from reaching the market. TJ Karim Khan from Pakistan has more on the story.
This is TJ Karim Khan from Peshawar in Pakistan. Whereas the military operation in Swat caused the civilians a great deal of trouble, farmers and fruit dealers of the area were affected in particular because they lost the prospective earnings from a whole season of labor in fields and orchards. Fruits like plums, peach and apricots went rotten while not picked from trees and could not be marketed due to the blockage of roads for traffic. However, farmers still hope to be able to save apples, persimmons and a few peach varieties from wasting away, provided that the curfew is lifted and the fruit is marketed in a week's time. It is expected that about 50% of the area's fruit can be saved and a loss of millions of rupees prevented if the government orders the curfew to be lifted before the 20th of July. This will save the efforts and livelihood of farmers, fruit dealers, and thousands of laborers.
If you want your voice to be heard by millions, let InstaBlog be your choice. You can contact us at cj@instablog.com. That's all for today's show. We'll be back with fresh updates and more citizen voices. Till then, it's goodbye from the entire team of Source 4.